And that's why we're going to the water park.
So you can impress the ladies. With what? Your disregard for your own life?
Nuh-uh. So I can win their hearts with my ice slide technique. I don't want to die sad and lonely like you.
I don't think there's much chance of that, if you try and ride the Eviscerator.
No?
Of course not.
You'll die slowly and painfully, in front of hundreds of terrified bystanders.
You know, it's pessimism like that that's making your species extinct.
Okay, okay, but we've been looking for the water park for hours. I thought you knew where we were going.
No, I do. I kinda. Oh, hey, you see those signs? Well, if you stand by them and press the action button, you'll receive a hint on how to progress. Come on, let's go!
Yeah, I'll catch up.
See that bird? Well, it's a possum. I need to keep a careful eye on him. One wrong move and that's it. You'll carry away for lunch.
Hey, where are you supposed to be?
He don't look like a possum. Well, look at that hair on his tail.
Should I get Ellie? I'm not sure about this guy.
Get it, Crash. He's not worth it.
Hey, buddy. Stay away from my sister. Or you'll have to deal with me.
If I find you following me in there, you're in for it. There's nuts in those caves, but don't be mistaken. Try to collect them, and I'll hear you. There's so many rustling bushes, I doubt you'll be able to sneak around without me hearing you.
Thank you. chicks back in their nest by bedtime. I'll be feeding you to them for breakfast. Now get going!
So hungry. So hungry that I can't even move. The only food I can find is at the top of that tree. I'm too hungry. Ugh, to climb it. More! I need more! Feeling better, just need a little more. Wow, that was great! I feel like a new bear.
I'm telling you guys, I heard a mammoth. It's just that stinky old bear.
Manny, you're just gonna have to face the facts. Maybe you're the last mammoth.
All right, come on, let's go. If there are any more mammoths out there, I'd love to find them hanging around here.
What's that you say? You're gonna try and climb that tree. You're pretty brave. Not like us possums. Listen, I'm going to help you. If you climb the tree far enough and fall from its branches, I'll give you a hand to get back up, okay?
For shame, Kiko. For shame. Are you really gonna let them get away with that?
I think he's gone soft.
Yeah, I think you're right. Oh, the Diego I used to know with his temper. Oh, no. He'd be using their bones as toothpicks by now. Ow! I think you've proved your point.
I'd have hit him a bit harder.
Manners, but there's been some strange stuff happening around here. Eggs have been mixed up in their nests. And since you're here, you can help sort things out. Return all the eggs to their correct nest, and I'll help you leave. But not until then! Watch out for some of the mother birds. If they catch you carrying eggs around, I don't know what they might do. Promised you.
Here it goes! ice melting, there's so much more mud to play in. Mud is so cool. Come on, guys, let's play.
Hey there, Furball.
If you want to join in, come and talk to me.
You need to pass the test before you can play. See if you can follow this pattern. Personally, I don't think anything as furry as you has the brains to outwit us.
Wow, you must be brighter than I thought.
Come join in. You can ride on our backs if you want.
Right? I bet you're after the swamp nuts. I hear they're really tasty, if you like that kind of thing. I know the swamp birds like them too. In fact, they stash some on their nesting platforms. I would bear if I were you. Well, you can tell which ones they are. They're the ones with the tall bushes growing on them. But I don't think you'll be able to reach them. Perhaps the swamp birds could give you a hand?
We took a little rest after our trip through the mud bog. Sid put his one and only talent to good use and made us a little campfire. Of course, even this got him into trouble. And then he had quite an unbelievable tale to tell about what happened that night. Whatever it was, I'm sure it was pretty weird and kind of scary in that Sid kind of way.
If you can beat me at digging, you can have my precious nut. Time to dig! Let's go nuts! You must have cheated! There's your nut!
Hey, stranger! Please feel free to give an awesome offering to the sacred fire totem. Check him out. Okay, just like toss the offering into his mouth and he'll be all like chomp chomp. Okay, different donations will affect different aspects of the totem, which is totally weird.
Hey, the fire ceremony calls for a nice hot fire soup. Achacha! I need 4 more chilies to really heat it up. Hey, you look like a forager. If you could bring me the chilies, hey, I'll give you a gift with my thanks. Bada bing, bada boom, how you doing? Thank you, my friend. I need 3 more chilies. Thank you, my friend. Hey, look at that in there. I need 2 more chilies. Thank you, my friend. Just 1 more chili to go, and then we're gonna have a proper fire soup, you know what I'm talking about! Thank you, my friend! Wow, that's what I call a real fire soup! Hey, thanks for the help, buddy. Here's a juicy nut for your troubles.
No, woe is me. A storm scared all my bojo birds last night. Now they are all hiding out of reach. If I don't have them all safe, I won't be able to go to the celebrations. If you're gonna help me out, I will make it worth your while. They're quite timid, so just chase them back to their nests. Thanks, stranger. Thanks to you, my birds are safe, and I can go to the celebrations. As promised, payment for all your hard work. A nice, shiny nut.
Hello again, mon frere. We can't conclude the ceremony for the fire god until the beacon on the mountain is all like lit up and going, woo! With your tail on fire, I'm sure you could totally ignite the fire water. Plus, you'd look awesome. You'd be all like, whoa! You know, I'm sure there's a tasty nut up there as well, Brilham.
Quit hanging around, maybe we can help each other get out of here.
Hmm?
Break those blocks with a stomp attack. That should be enough to load me down.
There are four in total. You know, you can use the vents to shoot yourself across to the far side.
Oh, be careful though. Jump short, and you'll be shot into the bubbling lava. That's right, just three more to go. That was well done, by the way. Another one? Well done! Ooh, you're something else, yeah.
Two more to go, though.
Great! You only have one more to go. Ah!
Oh! Ow.
Thanks, little guy. Come on, follow me and we'll get out of here.
The flood was starting to catch up with us. We woke up that morning in camp to find water everywhere. Sid seemed to have done some sleepwalking that night, but when he came back, we got moving as fast as we could. We got to the rescue boat only to find a scene of complete chaos. Just getting to the boat was not the end of our struggle. The water in the valley was getting more and more violent and washed Ellie away, trapping her in a cave. I knew I had to do something, and do something quick.
So, what exactly are you? Listen, cats don't like being wet. I'm not scared of the water, I just don't like it. The only way out of here is over there, but the roots flooded. We need to find a way to drain all of this flood water.
After a terrifying struggle and a race against time, something unforeseen but life-saving happened. The glacier cracked and the water in the valley drained out. And we're not sure how this happened, but we're not going to question a good thing. In the end, it all worked out. I found another mammoth, Diego got over his fear of water, and even Sid got a little respect. Just a little.